Good evening, friends. I am making this video as a response to the several questions I have received from people on my screenshot. Some questions are outright silly, so I will not address them. What I make is my business. The amount of worry people have about what I make, I'm very happy with it. I used to make X, why do I make Y now? I am getting old. I want to do what I am comfortable with. I will not make more or less money to satisfy anybody other than myself. Number two, people want to know what I do. Now that is a terrible idea if you want to copy me. Why? Because my mindset is very different from your mindset. It's like if you drive an X car, I will also buy the X car without caring about how much is my daily drive, how much is my budget, how do I plan to use the car. So, the right way of fixing your trading plan is to go to the Google University, Google Trade Plan, and you'll get 5 to 8 trading plans. See which one suits you. See if I was your regular seminar trainer, I would say, I will give you the magic key. This is the way I trade. This is my trading plan, and you will be profitable only if you follow my strategy, my trading plan. Anybody who is profitable, generally speaking, he will not be able to tell you what he does. It's the same with any sport. Adam Gilchrist, people from my generation would know, the Aussie wicketkeeper batsman. He was once invited to speak to some school students. And he was like, what am I going to say? And basically, I am paraphrasing. He said, I do what I do. And I cannot describe what I do. If you ask, people like Sehwag, etc., they don't have any strategy that they can explain in great detail. It's the way they understand the game. And it's the way they play. If somebody wants to rob you of money, he will tell you the strategy, and nothing but that strategy works. So stop getting fooled and work hard. Develop the strategy that works for your mindset, for your capital, for your view of the market. There are some traders who are mean reversion traders. There are other traders who are, breakout traders. You know what you are. So I cannot solve your problems, or I cannot make a trading plan to give it to you. You find that harsh, deal with it. If I am working hard on my game, I will benefit. If you want to benefit, please work hard on your game based on your needs and based on your mindset. This, cut, copy, paste, it worked in school. It does not work in trading. And that is the reason 90% of people will fail and they are already failing. So, do not assume that you will come to YouTube, you know, suck up to some trainer and you'll start trading like that trainer. First of all, 90% of trainers don't make money. So, you know, what I am advising you about life and about trading, if you don't work hard, if there is no sweat, blood, tears and pain, you will not get anywhere. You can sit with me and I will make money and you will make peanuts. So, this is one of the key learnings I want to give you, because I have no interest in your business or where you go for training, etc., etc., etc. The issue is that people compare it to some school or some engineering college or some place where you get a medicine degree. Everywhere 2 plus 2 is 4. In trading, 2 plus 2 can be 5, can be 6, can be 8. So, this is not a simple business where it's a yoga class and everybody does the yoga the same way and everybody benefits. This game is about, out of 100, only 10 will win. I'm talking about futures. Equity, 100 people buy Bajaj Finance, all 100 will gain. But futures is what you lose, I make. What I lose, somebody else makes. So, impossible to give a one-size-fits-all strategy. Now, the other thing is about stops. I put stops and wide stops, but at levels where I see that there is going to be strong support or resistance. Like at 11,600, when the market came back, a 100-point stop was enough. Why? Because we were at very strong support zones. Yesterday at 12,230 to 40, a 100-point stop was enough. Why? Because we were at a strong resistance. At 11,980, when we bounce back, I think on Monday, a 100-point stop was enough. If you randomly put 100-point stops without knowing where there are strong supports and where they are not, they will get hit. And that is the reason I try to go against the market when I see signs that the market may be turning from here, and then I put my 100-point stop underneath or over the market, as the case may be. About trade plan, I have a fair idea of where my exit could be. So that is how I manage my trades. I am continuously looking for signs of weakness. Which large caps are giving up ground? Are the mid caps coming off? So you have to watch for all of these things for advance signs. And that is how I believe in managing the trade. I want higher low, higher high type situations. I want that once a trade gets into a winning position, it should not lose money. So that is my style. Now you cannot copy it word for word, because there are many things involved here. It's like saying that if Tendulkar shows you how to play a stroke sitting in a room, you can go out and play, in a test match. There are many things involved. There are conditions that are involved. There is a type of bowling, which is against you. So, I find it very amusing the kind of, simplistic view people take of trading. So that would be it as far as my answers to questions on the screenshots are concerned. Trade well, keep working hard, keep solving one problem at a time, and finally you will get there. Okay, try to lose as little money as you can during your learning phase, and a lot of people are making this out to be about only levels. Yes, levels are important, but you have to add many other things to just levels to make it work. So don't get, don't become lakir ka fakir. That's all I can say. That should be it for this video. Take care and trade well.